Now, this is a pair question. Okay, so they have given mulberry plant and some pair as silk, Kashmiri goat, pashmina, cluster bean, guar gum, hemp, building materials. Okay, and they are asking that which of the above pairs has or have association with each other. Okay, so which of the above is having association with each other. So, the given pairs are having some relation with each other. So, we need to identify which of them are correct. Okay, so you can see this is the mulberry plant and the mulberry also. And from the primary level onwards, we are studying that the silks are made from the silkworm's cocoon. Right, and this silkworm grows only on this mulberry plants. So, you can see the silkworm here. Right, so silkworm will grow on the mulberry plant. Right, so mulberry leaves are the only leaves that silkworms will eat. Hence, silk production or the sericulture is related with the mulberry plant. Sericulture or silk production, it is related to mulberry plant because silk is produced from the cocoon of, or silk is produced from the shell of that this silkworm. Right, so silkworm is depending on the mulberry plants. So that's why mulberry plant and silkworm is having relation. Then you can see this is the pashmina goat. Okay, so pashmina goat, or we call it as Kashmiri goat. So it's a breed of goat found in the Kashmir region, mainly in the Kashmir region. And this, from the fur of this Kashmiri goat, we are producing the shawl known as pashmina shawl. Okay, so the pashmina shawl is made from the fur of a species known as Kashmiri goat or pashmina goat. Right. So pashmina is a fine type of Kashmiri wool, and that is used to produce shawls or some clothes. So pashmina is a fine type of Kashmiri wool, and pashmina has become known internationally as a term applied to the wool. Okay, and products made from the wool. So that is derived from the undercoat of the Kashmiri goat. Right. So this is the Kashmiri goat. So under this Kashmiri goat also they have some subspecies also. There are, I think, 3 to 4 subspecies also there in order to produce. So from all these Kashmiri goats, they are producing pashmina. Okay. So you can see the cluster bean image there, or gum there, right? So this cluster bean is mainly used in order to produce a gum, and that gum is known as guar gum, right? And that guar gum is mainly used in the production of shale gas, right? So we know that in US they are producing shale gas more. Okay, US is the leading country in for producing what, shale gas, right? And in order to produce this shale gas, we require most sophisticated mechanisms like fracking mechanism or hydraulic fracking. So hydraulic fracking is the mechanism used to what mine, or in order to extract this shale gas. So for this hydraulic fracking, they require gum called guar gum, right? So in order to improve the viscosity of that water, or in order to improve the viscosity of that liquid which is used to extract the hydraulic fracking mechanism. Okay, so that guar gum is used to increase the viscosity of the liquid, which is, that liquid is used in the fracking mechanism, right? So for that, there was a huge demand for cluster bean from India, right? So we were cultivating more, cluster bean. The farmers were cultivating this cluster bean because there was a huge increase in the demand for this cluster bean, right? So this cluster bean or guar gum is mainly extracted from or produced from the cluster bean, and that is used for the shale gas production, right? So the gum made from cluster bean or guar seeds is used in the extraction of shale gas, and it helps in improving the viscosity and flow of water in the fracking process. The gum is extracted from the Gorky Valley. Okay, Gorky Valley is the name, and grown mainly by farmers in arid lands in Rajasthan and Haryana. Okay, now regarding hemp, we know about marijuana, right? So this hemp is also a kind of plant which is related to marijuana plant. So hemp refers to non-psychoactive varieties of cannabis sativa. Okay, so both hemp and marijuana comes from the same cannabis species. So we know about this marijuana plant, right? But these are genetically distinct and are further distinguished by use, chemical makeup and cultivation methods. Okay, so marijuana and hemp both comes under same cannabis species, but genetically they are different. And regarding hemp, hemp is one of the oldest domesticated crops known to man. So this is the hemp cultivation. So that is hemp plant. Okay, this is the hemp cultivation, right? So the regarding the importance of hemp, hemp is having lots of importance. Okay, so its seeds and flowers are used in health foods, organic body care, and other nutraceuticals. Okay, so the seeds of this hemp and its flowers are used in the health foods. Okay, then this industrial hemp was the dyed fiber used to manufacture rope, canvas, and paper and clothing. So this industrial hemp is also used for producing ropes, in the manufacture of rope, in the manufacture of canvas, and in the paper manufacturing of paper, and also in clothing also we were using just hemp. So that much value is there for this hemp. So the fiber and seeds of this hemp, they are having incredible valuable, and is why hemp is often called a cash crop. So this hemp is also called cash crop because their seeds, their fiber, their flowers, all this are having incredible values. Then hemp building materials are another growing segment of the hemp industry. So hemp is also used for manufacturing materials, or it is used in building materials. So hemp building materials are another growing segment of the hemp industry, and it is also used in hemp oil, biofuel, plastic composite, and more. So this hemp is also used in the production of hemp oils, biofuels is also made from the hemp, and some plastic composite, it is also used in the manufacturing of plastic. Okay, manufacturing of plastic or in plastic composite also this hemp is using. So this much importance is there for hemp. Okay, so coming to the question again, they have given mulberry plant and the pear as silk. So that we discussed, right? So mulberry plant is aided by silkworms, and from silkworms we are producing silk, or sericulture is depending on silkworm, and it is depending on mulberry plant. So first pair is correct. So we eliminated B. Then second, Kashmiri goat and pashmina. So that also we discussed. Pashmina is a wool. Okay, pashmina is a wool, and that is mainly made from the under fur of, undercoat of Kashmiri goat, right? So second pair is also correct. So we eliminated C also. Then third, cluster bean. We discussed that cluster bean is used to produce the gour gum, and that gour gum is used in the production of extraction of shale gas. So the third pair is also correct. Then coming to hemp, hemp is used, they have given us building materials. So hemp is having high nutritional value, and it is used in the production of biofuel, bio oil, and also production of plastic materials, plastic composites, and also it is used in the building materials, production of building materials. Okay, and hemp is used in the textile industry, and it is used for the production of paper, used for the production of canvas, used for the production of ropes. Okay, so ropes, you know that ropes is also a kind of building material, right? So hemp is used for the building material industry also. So that's why fourth pair is also correct. So here the answer is D, 1, 2, 3, and 4. All the pairs are matched correctly. Okay.